Lucas, we're ready to start when you are.
All righty. Hello. Welcome to the show, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. My name's Lucas Miller. We're going to learn about animals today. Raise your hand if you like animals. Let me see those hands up. Yay. All right. I am going to teach you with some music. I've got some things that I'll show you up here. We're going to have lots of fun and learn all along the way. We're going to start off with a song about a wild cat. Yeah. So wild cats are things like mountain lions. We've got those in Texas. And we've got bobcats in Texas. And we've got this guy here called an ocelot. Isn't that a beautiful creature? Now, they're about twice as big as a house cat. So I could hold one in my arms like this. They're beautiful. They're very rare. We used to have a few thousand of them in Texas, but they've been hunted for a long time. We don't do it much anymore, but it used to be that if you wanted to wear that kind of pattern on your clothing, you had to go hunting for an ocelot. But today we can make those kinds of patterns without having to do that. But there's another spot every animal needs. Every animal needs a spot to live, right? And they live in these thick forests like this, real brushy. They like to creep through the grass looking for some things to eat, like rabbits and mice and snakes, and they pounce on them. So they've got to have good places to hide, real thick forests like this. But most of the forests they used to have now are farms and ranches. And we need farms and ranches, and we need places to live. But if we take all of the space and make it the way we like it, we won't have any ocelots. So we've got to save them some spots. This is a song called How Many Spots Has an Ocelot Got? And it's about how many spots do they have to live, not how many spots do they have all over their body. There's a spot down in South Texas called a wildlife refuge. And it's still that thick forest. This is where most of our ocelots in Texas live. There's only about 75 of them left in our state. And most of them live right there in that sort of park. And a few years back, some people that worked there asked me if I'd write a little ocelot song. And I did, and it goes like this. How many spots has an ocelot got? Has an ocelot got a lot of ocelot spots? How many spots has an ocelot got? Maybe not as many as you thought. You got it. I'm an ocelot and I'm looking for my spots. Yes, I got a lot of old black polka dots, but there's another kind of spot that I need a lot to hunt and to raise my little tots. I'm an ocelot who cannot find his spots. All right, help me now. How many spots has an ocelot got? Has an ocelot got a lot of ocelot spots? How many spots has an ocelot got? Maybe not as many as you thought. Oh yeah. I'm proud of the tip of Texas where it's scrubby and it's hot. Yeah, that's the kind of spot that my own good mama sought. Where she taught me to hunt in these thorny scrubby spots. I'm looking for my own Texas plot. And I will not cheer with any ocelot. All right, help me sing. How many spots has an ocelot got? Has an ocelot got a lot of ocelot spots? How many spots has an ocelot got? Maybe not as many as you thought. Oh yeah. Is that a good spot for an ocelot? Not. Is that a good spot for an ocelot? Not. Is this a good spot for an ocelot? Most definitely double knot. There's a nice ocelot spot. We like that a lot. Long ago in Texas, there were lots of ocelots. But cattle roads and fences, yeah, but, well, there's a battle being fought to save us ocelots. Come on, folks, don't let it be for naught. Won't you give this ocelot a lot of spots? One more time. Tom in this box has an ocelot gut. Has an ocelot got a lot of ocelot spots. Tom in this box has an ocelot gut. Maybe not a mini, itty bitty itty, but we can give him plenty of those spots. All right. Let's hear it for the ocelots up here. Those guys love it. I hope you guys loved it too. All right. I'm going to make myself big here on the screen again. If you have any comments or questions, you can type them in to the Zoom feed box. I can see those. And otherwise, I will just keep it rolling right along. We are going to do one now about the different things that animals eat. Some animals eat meat, right? Like an ocelot. An ocelot is a carnivore. Do you know that word? That's a meat eater. So there's lots of kinds of carnivores. I bet we can think of some. Let's see here. Where is my remote control? There we go. A shark. Oh, that's a carnivore out in the ocean. There are carnivores up in the sky, like eagles. There are carnivores like the wildcats, ocelots, and cheetahs are also carnivores. And then there are carnivores in the swamps. I bet you can think of a carnivore in the swamp. An alligator. Then there are creatures that don't like to eat meat. They just eat plants. And if you just eat plants, you're called a herbivore. So we're talking about deer, cows, giraffes, and koalas. Isn't that a cute koala? They like to eat leaves called eucalyptus leaves. So they're herbivores. Some animals eat bugs. Now, a lot of people don't know this word. It's not bugivore. Scientists don't usually use the word bug. They use the word insect. So an animal that eats bugs we call an insectivore. All right? A frog eats bugs. They're an insectivore. A chameleon. That's an insectivore too. They eat lots of bugs. And then there are bats. Ooh, I love those bats. And a hedgehog. They eat bugs too. Yeah, insectivores. Now, some creatures will eat just about anything. Most of us will eat some meaty stuff, going to eat some plant stuff. You never know. Some of y'all eat bugs too, I guess. And if you eat a little bit of whatever, that is called an omnivore. Yeah, and an omnivore is something like a bear. Or a skunk. Uh-oh, pee-you. A possum. Or a warthog. So these are all omnivores. And then I've got a song now that'll help you learn those words if you don't know them already. This is called the Chimichanga Song. And I actually kind of recorded this ahead of time so that I could show you everything just right. So I'm going to play that for you right now. Oh, yeah. Well, it was a beautiful day. I headed down to the zoo. I took a walk around for an hour or two. Well, I got hungry. I saw a Tex-Mex food stand. I was happy, cause I am a chimichanga fan. And when they take a big tortilla and they stuff it with the stuff you like, then they drop it in a big deep fryer till it's fried up just right. It's fried up just right. I do love a good chimichanga. Well, I got in line like I'm supposed to do. But ahead of me, I saw a kangaroo and a snake and a frog. You can imagine my surprise when the frog hopped right up and said with a gleam in his eye, a gleam in his eye, I'm an insectivore.
He's an insectivore. Give me what I adore. What do you adore? I want some bugs, bugs, bugs in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Like some spiders and some beetles and a big cockroacheroo. They're so tasty and delicious and nutritious too. I want some bugs, bugs, bugs in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Anybody want a bite? The frog hopped off and he found a seat with his deep fried flies. He started to eat and then the snake slithered up with a smile and a hiss and ordered her order. It went something like this. Something like this. I'm a carnivore.
She's a carnivore.
Give me what I adore.
What do you adore?
I want some meat, meat, meat in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Like some mouses and some birdies in a great big rat-a-roo. They're so tasty and delicious and nutritious too. Yeah, I want some meat, meat, meat in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. I can't decide which end looks better. The snake slithered off with a fuzzy wuzzy dish. It was kangaroo's turn to declare her wish. With slobber and drool dripping down off her chin, she hopped right on up and she said with a grin, she said with a grin, I'm a herbivore.
She's
a herbivore. Give me what I adore.
What do you adore?
I want some plants, plants, plants in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Like some grass and some leaves and some sprouts and shoots a roo. They're so tasty and delicious and nutritious too. Well, I want some plants, plants, plants in my chimichanga. Make it your manga.
Excuse you.
Kangaroo hopped off with a vegetarian treat. It was my turn now to say what I like to eat. After all I had seen, you might think I'd feel ill. But I stepped right on up, I said, I want my fill. So give me my fill. I'm an omnivore.
He's you remember what they eat?
Give me what I adore.
What do
meat
you
and
adore?
Plants. I want some meat and plants in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Like some chicken and some beans and some good old rice-a-roo. They're so tasty, delicious, and nutritious too. I want some meat and plants in my chimichanga. Make it your manga. Make it your manga.
Put your hands together for the chimichanga song. There we go. Those guys love it. I think they're ready for some more.
And I'm back. All right, I hope you liked the chimichanga song. Now we're going to talk about a place with lots of food because there's lots of plants. And that means more food for the plant eaters, right? Yeah, lots of plants, that means there'll be lots of herbivores. If there are lots of herbivores, there will be lots of carnivores because there will be more herbivores for those carnivores to eat. That's the way it works. Wherever there are lots of plants, you have lots of animals too. That's why you have so many more living things in a rainforest than a desert. Now, there's a place in Texas that's kind of like a rainforest. It's called a wetland. And a wetland is a land that is wet. Yep, they're usually right along the edge of a river or the ocean. This is a wetland called a swamp, which has lots of trees. This is a wetland with lots of grass. This kind of wetland is called a marsh. They're usually along the edge of a river like this, or maybe along the coast. Now, they provide habitat
to lots of creatures. They're muddy. They're stinky. Pee you! And they're buggy. So most of us don't like them. But here's some creatures that like them. There's lots of birds in the wetlands. You might spot a marsh rabbit or a deer in a wetland. Frogs are in the wetlands. I love those frogs. Turtles are in the wetlands. And so are the alligators. Now, if you like to go fishing, remember that most of the fish you want to catch need wetlands. It's where they grow up. So you want to catch this guy in the deep water. Just remember that it used to be a baby fish, and that's where the cute little baby fish grow up, is in the wetlands. Now, one more thing that they do is they protect us from floods. So when we get a lot of rain and the storms in the late summer, these wetlands are going to protect us. They're going to stand guard. And when the waves start crashing ashore, those waves are going to hit those grasses, and then they won't be able to get much farther. So they protect us from floods, too. Now, I could talk about wetlands some more and go blah, 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 but I thought you might like it better if I did a little rap song. Are you ready for some rapping? I hope so. Are you ready for some really bad rapping? You better be, because bad rapping is the only kind of rapping I do. When I get to the part that we sing, I'm going to get you putting your hands together like this, going like that. I'll teach you as we go along. Let's go ahead and get this song started right now. Oh, yeah. Looking good. Now, listen up, y'all. I got a little lesson in wetland ecology for you. What a gas, better look fast, bet you never heard a rap from a blade of grass. Well, I'm a reed, reed is my name. You're gonna be digging me next time I get a lot of rain. Me and my cousins soak up a whole lot of water, keeping things balanced like living on a teeter-totter. A roots go down, sponge your mud like a game of Red Rover. We holding back a mighty flood, come on out and visit. You're gonna see us standing tall, waving at you. Here we go. Oh yeah, all right, here's your part now. We're living in a wetland, wetland, wetland. That's right, right there where the water meets the dry, dry land. Oh yeah, we're living in a wetland, wetland, wetland. Talking about all the herons, alligators, and clams. That's right, hold it man. I'm a clam. My name is Sam. Sam the clam. I am. I slip the water in through my snorkel-like snout. I filter out the floaties, then I squirt the water out. I'm eating plankton, the little pins and critters floating in the water, teeny tiny like glitter. Pollution in the water hurt the human and the otter. I have a heart, do my part like I know a otter. I store that bad stuff down in my inside, cleaning up the water through the low and high tide. Low tide, high tide, low tide. Here we go. Living in a wetland, wetland, wetland. Let's see it. Right there where the water meets the dry, dry land. Oh yeah. We're living in a wetland, wetland, wetland. Talking about all the herons, alligators, and clams. That's right. Excuse me a minute, cause I gotta get bossy. My name is Maurice, captain of the river, posse 20 foot long. King of the alligator. Spend my days hoping up on contaminator. Me and my party, we can take care of the toxin. Gasoline, sewage, phosphate, dioxin. Join our party. Be an ambassador. We don't want to go extinct like the dinosaur. Cause there are fish, amphibians, and reptile. Bugs and birds by the billion. Gonna chill a wild water snake. On the hunt for a bullfrog. Hooping crane, hooping it up in the morning fog. Willow is a snack for the beavers with the flat tail. Muskrat like to hang by the cattail. This is a habitat for so many species. Like a puzzle, the picture's incomplete unless you save all of the pieces. Now we're gonna sing it like we're underwater. Are you ready to get crazy? Here we go. you got it. We're out there where the water meets the dry land. Oh yeah, wet land. Talking about all that hair runs out of alligators on plans.
Now, if you inspect and you take yourself a really close view, you'll reflect on how much we do for you. Genuflect, that means you get down on your knees and respect, because we'll give you so much that you need. Put your hands together for the wetlands out there. Or your flippers, whatever you got. Alrighty, let's keep it rolling and rocking here. Let's do one now about some creatures you might hear singing in the wetlands when the sun goes down. Can you think of somebody? I'm thinking about the frogs. Frogs are singing. At least the boy frogs are singing. The girl frogs really don't sing. The boy frogs are only singing to impress the girl frogs. So they're saying stuff like, hey, good looking, I'm available, uh-huh. And the girl frogs are like,
ooh, he sounds so cute. I gotta hop off and find him.
Boing, boing, boing. That is why not all frogs go ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Now, you've heard that sound before, but not around the pond. You've heard it on TV. There's a frog that sounds like that, but it lives way out on the west coast of the USA, places like California. We don't have any frogs that go ribbit. If they all went ribbit, you'd get little bitty guys like this one called a spring peeper, and she'd hear that sound. She'd have to hop off. Boingity, 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 boing. She'd spend a lot of time and energy looking for that boy frog calling out,
yoo-hoo, where did you go?
And then she might find the wrong kind of frog. She'd be like, ew, you are not my species.
Get your big old green stuff out of here. Goodbye.
So they've all got to make their own call. And a spring peeper calls out, and it sounds kind of like a bird. There's a frog around here that sounds a lot like this. You can hear him in January, right after New Year's, maybe in December too. There's the bullfrog, which is a bigger frog, so it has a much lower call. You ready for it? Somebody thought it sounded like a bull. I think it sounds like a moose that had too much cafeteria food. Ugh. And then you've got the coastal plain toad. Now, if you've got a toad in your yard, this is who it is, most likely. And if you go out tonight and take a listen, you might hear their call. They sing pretty much all year round. If there's been rain in the last week or so, you can usually hear him out there. This is a little bitty guy called a cricket frog, and you can hear them in the streams around here. You probably think it's a bug because it sounds like somebody clacking rocks together. That doesn't sound anything like ribbit, does it? That is a call you'll hear around here, though. If you go out later today near the neighborhood stream, I bet you will hear that sound. The green frog sounds like somebody snapping a rubber band. And if you think that one sounds funny, get ready for the pig frog. The pig frog sounds like a pig. I just don't know which end of the pig it sounds like the most, if you know what I mean. And then you've got the eastern narrow-mouthed toad. A little bitty guy, and they're pretty rare, but I love their sound. They sound like a very upset baby. Here comes a whole bunch of them. Sounds like they all want their diaper changed right now, right? Yeah. Now, if you go to that pond the next day, you may find some little frog eggs in that water. Those little eggs are clear. There's a little dark spot in the middle. There's no shell. They look like little jelly things. And that is where they start life. And then out of the egg comes something that looks really different from a frog, right? It's called a tadpole. And that tadpole changes slowly into a frog. Now, we're going to do a song about that change from one form to another. When you change your body like that, it is called a metamorphosis. Let me hear that word. Metamorphosis. Now, this song will teach you that word very well, and it's going to go like this. It's about this guy right here. Metamorphosis, metamorphosis. I'm going to be more than this. Wait and see. He looks like a fish. Metamorphosis. I'm at the metamorphosis, but he's not a fish. I'm gonna transform from this tadpole to a frog. That's right. Now gather round upon my little tadpoles, and I will sing you a song of metamorphosis. Once upon a wet land, I was stuck inside an egg, and there wasn't very much to see. So I wiggled and I broke free. I kinda look like a fishy, with my tail going swishy. I got gills on my neck, I got no legs yet. Just you wait, and you will see. A metamorphosis, metamorphosis. I'm gonna be more than this. Wait and see. Are you ready to help me sing? Metamorphosis, metamorphosis. I'm gonna transform from this tadpole into a frog.
Tadpoles. I'm a tadpole.
Now the days go by. Everybody look at me. More like a frog I'm beginning to be. I'm kicking with my little back legs back there, growing lungs for breathing air. Does my tail look smaller to you? Tell me true. I'm a transformer, it is true. Soon front legs are gonna sprout, and my eyes will start bugging out. Well, I always believe, and in sweet time, I know that I will achieve. All right, now, metamorphosis, let me hear it. Metamorphosis, you got it. Gonna be more than this. Wait and see. There are those front legs. Metamorphosis, metamorphosis. Well, I'm gonna transform from this tadpole into a frog. That's right. You know what happens next? The tail back there is gonna start getting shorter and shorter and shorter. And then his tongue is going to start getting longer and longer and longer. Coming soon to a lily path near you, a great big frog is so brand new. And I'll be hopping on the riverside, boing, hunting for a dragonfly. Gonna catch it with my long and sticky tongue, and take a deep breath with my new lungs. Well, I a song in the sun, for this new life I've begun. So just you wait, cause I guarantee. Metamorphosis, metamorphosis. Boing, gonna be more than this. Boing, wait and see. Boing, boing. Metamorphosis, hello. Metamorphosis. Yeah, I'm gonna transform from this tadpole into a frog. One more time. Gonna transform from this tadpole into a frog. All right. Put your hands together for those tadpoles out there. Woohoo!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you.
All righty. Let's do one more song. Now, this one is another carnivore song. It is about the world's heaviest snake. Do you know who the world's heaviest snake is? It is called the green anaconda. Yeah, they're known to get 200 to 300 pounds. That's a lot more than I weigh. And they are famous because they are so big, and they are famous because they made a lot of movies and a lot of YouTube videos and a lot of old stories and tall tales about anacondas. But you know, if you want to find out the facts about something, the movie theater is not the best place to go. It's a good place for a story, but they don't usually give you the facts. YouTube's got some good stuff, but they've also got some crazy stuff that's just wrong, wrong, wrong. You've got to go to a place where it's sorted out. There's a place you can go where they've got some fun stories in one section, and then in another section, they've got the factual stuff. So if you want stories, you go here, and if you want facts, you go here. And that place is called your library. That's right. It is still the best place to get the facts about animals or anything else for that matter. Now, if you want a book, they've got those, but they can also help you get to the good resources online too to find the facts. It's very, very important. And the library is the best place to go. They are information specialists. They are truth detectives. Everything they do is meant to make sure you're getting the information that you want or the stories that you want. Let me start my guitar here. I was driving down the road after one of those crazy anaconda movies came out, and this old song came on the radio. I'm so little. This is a song called La Bamba, and you'll see why I'm so little in just a second. And I changed La Bamba into the Anaconda La Bamba. And it goes like this. Now that move. Whoops, wait a minute. Oh, I messed up. Here we go. Whoops. Nope, that's not it either. Okay, hang on. There we go. Sorry. You know the movie Anacondas. They always got it all wrong. That's why I made up this song. Down in the Amazon. Yeah, that is where they belong. I am awfully, awfully fond of this natural phenomenon, phenomenon. Here's your part. I want you to help me out. It goes like this. So everybody sing anaconda. Anaconda. Riva! Anaconda. Yeah, you're all right with me. Let's try that together. Are you ready? Here we go now. So everybody go anaconda. Let's hear it. Anaconda. Anaconda. Yeah, you're all right with me. Oh, yeah. Give me an ay, 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 ay. Are you ready? Here comes another verse for you now. I go like this. Now it will astound ya, down the green anaconda, like you live in a swamp with piranha down in South America, some over 20 feet long, and yes, that is humonga, and they're incredibly strong, some weigh 300 pounds, so everybody sing anaconda, let's hear it, anaconda, oh yeah. Anaconda, you're all right with me. Oh yeah, another verse for you now. Now it will astound ya, all that they gobble down, deer, birds, and iguanas, and 100-pound capybaras. They scare the women named Wanda. Yep. They scare the women named Rhonda and Jane Fonda and spies named James Bonda. But I'm more scared of a Honda or the lunch lady's lasagna. That is some of the scary stuff, right? Here we go.
So everybody go anakana, anakana, anakanda. Yeah, you're all right with me. To know the true anakanda, don't believe all the hoopla and the brouhaha you see in the cinema. Oh no, get on your bike and ride down to the library in your town. I wander around until you have found a nonfiction book on anacondas, or maybe an encyclopedia if you know what those are. All right, one more time, let's sing it loud and proud. Everybody go anaconda. Anaconda, anaconda, you're all right with me. All right, let me see you put your hands together for the anacondas of the world. Those guys, they're my biggest fans right there. Okay. I think it is about time for us to see if you've got some questions or anything else that you want to talk about. I will be looking at the Zoom chat here. I'll also be able to hear it, I think. Real quick, before we get there, I do have a YouTube channel. So if you would like to look me up on YouTube, nope, it's not there. Look up Singing Zoologist. Just type in singing, and then start with Z-O-O, and YouTube will fill in the rest of it for you. So I've got a lot of good stuff on YouTube, and I believe you'll be able to watch this performance again, too, on YouTube. I have a Facebook page as well, and I will be doing a free show every Tuesday at 11 o'clock. There'll be one song and some cool information. Next week, we're going to learn about bats. So if you want to find out more about bats, look up my Facebook page, which is Lucas Miller, the Singing Zoologist, here again. So remember, singing in zoo, and I think you'll find me on Facebook, too, without any trouble. Okay, questions, if you've got them, type them in, or we'll see if I can maybe hear them. I am going to grab some headphones so that I can, some different headphones, in case we've got any questions here. And I got to grab my glasses too, because, yeah, that's where I am in life now. Okay, question up there. All right. Can we do it again? Yes, you can do this again. You can watch it. I believe they're going to have it on their the library Facebook page. And then, like I said, I'll be live again and again every Tuesday at 11 o'clock is when we're going to be doing that for now. I'm going to kind of maybe play with the time to see what works best. But next week's at 11, I'm probably going to leave it there. Any other questions? You guys have been awesome. I really, really appreciate you coming and listening. I hope you enjoyed it. And we've got a lot of people here. Let's see. All right. Well, I'm not seeing any questions or anything like that. I think that's going to wrap it up. You guys have been so fun. You all have been my first live streaming library audience of my entire career. I've done thousands and thousands of shows, but never have I been able to do a live show through the internet for a library before. So I'm really excited about that. I had one snafu at the beginning of the Anaconda song, but actually this is one of my least problematic streaming videos. I've had a lot of issues when we first started self-isolating. I started doing live stuff on Facebook, and every single show had something go wrong. All right, well, I'm going to let it go. Okay, thank you all. Appreciate it. I'm going to go ahead and log off. See you later, Joshua. See you later, Emmanuel. See you later, Erica. See you later, Danielle, Laurel, Tommy, and Anna. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for watching.